Now the road to the trophy. The 2012 CBS Caremark Charity Classic is still underway. The tournament wraps up later today after a surprise at the top of the leaderboard. For some time, tournament hosts Brad Faxon and Billy Andrade were among the top players. But at last check, overall, they had fallen to just 11 under par. Regardless of the outcome, though, it's already a big payday for so many Rhode Island charities. And Eyewitness News reporter Andrew Adamson joins us live on the links now with the East Bay Mobile Newsroom. Andrew?
Yeah, it's not even just the golfers that are the winners out here. It's a win-win situation for everybody. Not only is there plenty of variety and entertainment for fans, but also some much-needed money for local charities.
A day at the Rhode Island Country Club has a little something for everyone when the CVS Caremark Charity Classic comes to town. Just ask the Lewis family.
And all the different events and the skins game and the closest to the pin and the long drive, excellent. It's a lot of fun.
While those events were fun for the Lewises, some were also very special for local charities. When Corey Pavin captured the closest to the pin title on Monday, he also earned $25,000 for Youth Pride, Inc.
The $25,000 goes really far in terms of helping kids who are gay or lesbian or transgender really try and find safe space.
Reps from Youth Pride, Inc. got to personally thank Pavin today before he teed off in the final round of the scramble.
Great job.
I'm glad I could do that for you.
CVS Caremark Charity Classic Tournament Chairman Eileen Howard Boone says this is what really drives the tourney.
And it's really all about our charities. It's our local nonprofits that are really making a difference in the lives of those that need it the most.
Another reason why the Classic is unlike any other and why the Lewises say they'll definitely be back again next year.
And one more lucky charity will actually also win $25,000 today in round two of the Closest to the Pin Challenge. We're going to have full coverage of the rest of this event, so make sure you stay tuned on air and online. Live with East Bay Mobile Newsroom, Andrew Adamson, Eyewitness News.